Problem four. There are 2019 penguins waddling towards their favourite restaurant. As the penguins arrive, they're handed tickets numbered in ascending order from 1 to 2019 and told to join the queue. The first penguin starts the queue. For each n greater than 1, the penguin holding ticket number n finds the greatest m less than n, which divides n, and enters the queue directly behind the penguin holding ticket number m. This continues until all 2019 penguins are in the queue. A. How many penguins are in front of the penguin with ticket number 2? B. What numbers are on the tickets held by the penguins just in front of and just behind the penguin holding ticket 33? So when you first see this problem, it's probably not at all obvious what's happening. So maybe the best thing to do is just to take the first few penguins and see what happens to them. Then maybe we can get a feel for the problem. So penguin 1 arrives first, and they form the start of the queue. Next, penguin 2 arrives. They come along immediately behind penguin 1, but I'm going to leave a lot of space for them so that lots of other penguins can fit in between later. Then penguin 3 comes along, and they join the queue behind penguin 1. Penguin 4 comes along, joins the queue immediately behind penguin 2. Penguin 5 joins the queue straight behind penguin 1. Penguin 6 then joins behind penguin 3. Penguin 7 behind penguin 1. Penguin 8 behind penguin 4. And then penguin 9 behind penguin 3. That still looks like a bit of a mess. We can start looking at the questions we were asked and seeing if we can say anything about them. So the first one was to do with the penguins either side of penguin 2. And it does look from what we've done so far that the penguins behind penguin 2 will be the penguins with numbers that are powers of 2. So penguin 4, penguin 8, penguin 16 and so on. We should look at that pattern and see if it continues. So here are penguins 2, 4 and 8 as discussed. Let's see what happens with the other powers of 2. I mean, certainly the other powers of 2 do fall in as we'd expect. So penguin 16 joins the queue behind penguin 8, penguin 32 behind penguin 16, penguin 64 behind penguin 32, penguin 128 behind penguin 64, penguin 256 behind penguin 128, penguin 512 behind penguin 256, and penguin 1024 behind penguin 512. The other thing we should worry about is why no other penguins find themselves behind penguin 2. Let's see what would happen. Suppose a penguin joins the queue behind penguin 2 to the k. Well, in order for 2 to the k to be that penguin's biggest factor, it would have to be of the form 2 to the k times a. A, of course, would have to be an odd number for us to be interested, because we've already dealt with what happens if it's a power of 2, and we can just take powers of 2 out to write it in the form 2 to the ka. But the largest factor of this is not a power of 2. The largest factor is 2 to the k minus 1a, because this is obtained by dividing by 2, which is smaller than any odd number bigger than 1. So this will be a bigger factor than 2 to the k. So other penguins join the queue somewhere else. They don't join the queue behind a penguin whose number is a power of 2. As a result, these penguins here are the end of the queue. So let's see. There are 2019 penguins in total. Including penguin 2, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 penguins that are penguin 2 or behind. So the number of penguins in front of penguin 2 is the other 2009 penguins. Let's now look at the second question we were asked, which is to do with the neighbours of penguin 33, once all the penguins have arrived. It'll be quicker to look at the penguin immediately behind 33, so I'll start with that. Which penguins join immediately behind 33? Well, the first one to do so is penguin 66, which is twice 33. So 66 joins immediately behind 33. But I'll leave a gap, because penguin 99 will later turn up, and they'll also join immediately behind 33. Do any other penguins join behind Penguin 33? Well, no. If they did, they'd have to be Penguin 33P, where P is a prime number, and P would have to be a prime number that was 5 or more, because we've dealt with 2 and 3. But given that this number has a factor of 3, because 33 is a multiple of 3, this penguin would in fact join behind penguin 11p. So if it was 33 times 5, for example, that would in fact join behind penguin 55. So no more penguins join the queue behind 33, leaving 99, the penguin immediately behind 33 at the end of the game. Now let's look at the penguin that ends up immediately in front of 33. In order to do this, remember that penguin 33 will have joined the queue immediately behind penguin 11. Loads of other penguins end up between, so I'll leave lots of space. The first penguin to join behind penguin 11 was penguin 22, but penguin 22 is somewhere over here because they joined before penguin 33. The first penguin to join behind penguin 11 but after penguin 33 is penguin 55. So once penguin 55 joins the queue, they're immediately in front of penguin 33. Then the first penguin to join immediately behind 55 is penguin 110. Other penguins might join behind 55, but they'll be doing so later, so they'll be in here. Similarly, the first penguin to join immediately behind 110 is penguin 220. Again, other penguins might join in here, but that doesn't matter. We care about the penguin that's going to be closest to 33. Similarly, the first penguin to join the queue behind 220 is 440. Then the first penguin to join immediately behind 440 is 880. And then the first penguin to join immediately behind 880 is 1760. So at the end of the process, the penguin immediately in front of penguin 33 is penguin 1760.